that she was moving on with another man. Police think that's likely why an estranged husband waited for his wife at work in Fort Thomas, Kentucky, and tried to kill her. WLWT NewsSize Curtis Fuller has the new developments tonight as police now close their case. Curtis?
Well, Sheree, first, I talked with Alicia Waters' family as she remains in the hospital tonight. Of course, their main focus is any little progress she can make in her long road to recovery. Meanwhile, investigators followed all their leads, spoke to numerous witnesses, and tonight, a look inside the hours before that tragic shooting.
Leading up to this deadly day in Fort Thomas, police concluded that Dennis Mathis had become enraged because of his estranged wife, Alicia Waters' relationship with her new boyfriend. They say he tried just about everything to track them down.
Calling the family members, acting like he was a dispatcher at one time, stating that he'd received a 911 call from the phone number that he was calling Alicia's family members, stating that they needed to know for their records where they were located.
Alicia Waters was shot several times by Mathis. She is now paralyzed. Mathis killed himself. The couple was going through a divorce. Police say on the morning of August 6th, Mathis arrived early at the one place where he knew he would find at least Waters, at her job in Fort Thomas. A worker told him he could not park in their lot.
He moved the vehicle, but what he did, he moved it to an adjacent building complex, parked in the rear so Alicia would not be able to see him. And from my witnesses, that when she arrived at the scene, he came running from the building between two cars and ambushed her right there in the lot.
Waters was denied a permanent restraining order against him. Mathis purchased a gun the day before the shooting. Police say he was checked out and was legally allowed to obtain that weapon.
Alicia, she looks apparently, she's going to be a quadriplegic the rest of her life, which is tragic. And, and he's not around to ask him or hold him accountable for his actions.
Again, as I said, I talked to Alicia Waters' family tonight. They have set up a blog to update the public on her condition. They also plan to speak out to make sure what happened to Alicia does not happen to anyone else. Sheree?